Good morning, students. Today we will discuss about the fungal viruses or mycoviruses. In our previous lecture we have discussed about various type of viruses like human viruses, plant viruses, animal viruses, bacteriophage and algal viruses. Their isolation, identification and characterization, cell culture system, taxonomy and in vivo cell culture system and their identification at molecular level. Today we will discuss about an introduction of fungal viruses or mycoviruses. There are uncountable examples of many plant and bacterial viruses that cause severe symptoms of the disease. Virus of the fungi, also known as mycoviruses, in fact, many medically and commercially useful and important fungi, but frequently do not cause obvious sign of disease in fungus. Mycoviruses or virus of the fungi are viruses that replicate within the fungal cells or fungi. As we know that viruses required a host cell to replicate. Without host cell, the virus cannot replicate. These fungal viruses were first discovered from the contaminated mushroom and from penicillin that stimulated the production of interferon in mammals. Mycoviruses discovered in the plant filamentous fungal pathogen in the 1970s, their entire life cycle occurs exclusively within their host cell. Mycoviruses or fungal viruses replicate within the fungi but never released from the infected cell to the environment directly. So far, more than 250 mycoviruses have been isolated from the various type of fungi, including mushroom, medical fungi, plant pathogenic fungi. These sequenced and registered in the NCBI database, we can assess from there. The fungal viruses have single-stranded or double-stranded RNA genome as well as or DNA genome. Mycoviruses are clustered into several families, including Totiviridae, Parotitiviridae, Carrizoviridae, Hypoviridae and Nanoviridae family and many more. Diversity and taxonomy. The coming slides will discuss about the diversity and the taxonomy. The fungal viruses have diverse genome including linear double-stranded RNA genome. So the viruses belongs to double-stranded RNA or contains double-stranded RNA genome belongs to the Carrizoviridae family, Andornaviridae family, Megavirnaviridae family, Quadriviridae family, Parotitiviridae family, Rheoviridae family, and Totiviridae family. The another type of RNA, which is positive sense single-stranded RNA. This type of virus is currently classified into the alpha flexiviridae, Bernaviridae, gamma flexiviridae, Hypoviridae, and Narnaviridae family. The negative sense single-stranded RNA viruses classified into mycomononviridae, gaviviridae, and single-stranded DNA remains unclassified. Mycoviruses with double-stranded DNA genome are missing from the list, but double-stranded DNA viruses are classified into protista, but not fungi. So here we are giving the few examples of various type of family of mycoviruses. The Totiviridae family, double-stranded RNA. So this type of viruses were classified into Totiviridae, Parotitiviridae, Megavirnaviridae, Carrizoviridae, Quadriviridae, Quadriviridae, Rheoviridae, Andornaviridae, Andornaviridae family. These type of viruses were classified, which viruses have double-stranded RNA or single-stranded RNA were classified into Andornaviridae family. Alpha-flexiviridae family contains or classified in this family the viruses which contains the positive sense RNA genome classified into alpha-flexiviridae, Bernaviridae, gamma-flexiviridae, Hypoviridae, Narnaviridae, and the negative sense RNA viruses classified into mycomonan gaviviridae. Reverse transcribing mycoviruses were classified in this family. Here we Here we are discuss about the few fungal examples and their related viruses. So mycoviruses in the Cryphonectrica parasitica. Chestnut blight is a parasitic fungal disease of chestnut tree caused by the ascomycete fungus C. parasitica, and the viruses infect this fungus given below. So this fungus parasitica viruses 1CHV1, which is the hypovirulence associated mycoviruses of the parasitica. This fungus belongs to the of hypoviridae, or we can say the this type of viruses were classified in the hypoviridae family. And those viruses which belong to this fungus classified in the hypoviridae family was reported in 1991. Hypoviridae family contains a single genus of hypoviruses and four viruses species, namely CHV1, CHV2, CHV3, CHV4 and other viruses as well. The fungal viruses in Sclerotinia sclerosiorum. The sclerosiorum hosts various mycoviruses, including double-stranded RNA, single-stranded RNA viruses, and the single-stranded circular DNA viruses as well. Sclerosiorum hypovirulence associated DNA viruses. This virus is also known as SSHADV1. Is the first DNA mycoviruses that was found to infect fungi and provide hypovirulence. The hypovirulence means less able to cause disease. This mycoviruses is related to the plant Gemini viruses. Sclerotinia sclerosiorum debilitation associated RNA viruses SSDRV and sclerosinia sclerosiorum RNA virus LSSRVL are co-infected in the strain EP1PN of sclerosinia sclerosiorum. Both of these fungal viruses have a simple RNA genome that codes for one gene only, that is RNA replicase. SSDRV is closely related to viruses in the family Alpha Flexibility and genus Sclerodernavirus. Mycoviruses in Rosellinia negatrix. White root rot or Dermatophora root rot is a pathogenic fungal disease caused by the ascomycete Rosellinia negatrix. The most destructive disease of the many woody plants, the viruses and their related family given below. Rosellinia negatrix hosts various mycoviruses family, namely Rheoviridae, Partitiviridae, Carisoviridae and Totiviridae family. A hypovirulence associated dsRNA, double-stranded RNA viruses, Rosellinia negatrix, Megabirnavirus 1, RNMBV1. This virus is also known as RNMBV1 in short form. Belongs to the Megabirnaviridae family. Four segment double-stranded RNA virus, Rosellinia negatrix, Quardivirus, RNQV1, and RNQV2 belongs to the Quardivirid family. Fungal viruses in Botrytis species. Gray mold disease caused by the pathogenic Botrytis species is one of the most widespread and the destructive fungal disease of the crops and fruits. Botrytis virus FBVF belongs to the Mycoflexivirus in the family Gamma Flexibility family. Botrytis virus XBVX belongs to Botrex virus and the family Alpha Flexibility. Their genome size, here we are discuss about the few example of the few family and their genome size. Genome size of the fungal double-stranded RNA viruses Ryoviridae, their genome size approximately 19.2 clovis pair. Totiviridae, the size of their genome 4.6 clovis pair approximately. And Paritiviridae, 1.7 kbp approximately. And Chrysoviridae, their genome size 3.2 approximately kbp. So the structure of the viruses or structural features of the mycoviruses. 3D structural analysis have focused to date on those mycoviruses which double-stranded RNA genome and a single-layered isocitral capsid. All appears to lack an extracellular phase in their life cycle, and virus particles accumulate in the fungal cytoplasm. These particles can usually be purified in the large amount with good structural preservation, enabling their characterization by 3D cryo-electron microscopy and the X-ray crystallography. So this is the structure of Totiviridae family. And Penicillium Stoloniferum virus F and PCV with linker segment A, B, C respectively. So A represent the 3D figure A represent the 3D structure of mycoviruses capsid of totiviruses. SCVL a view of isocitral symmetry showing the capsid protein in blue and yellow color respectively. Capsid of the Paritivirus Penicillium Stoloniferum virus F B. Capsid of Carisovirus PCV with linker segment in red in C diagram. So their transmission. The transmission of the mycoviruses are transmitted to a new host by cell division or cell to cell fusion. Mycoviruses vertically transmitted via host spores, asexual spores. Research has shown that the ascospores of a virus infected strain might be infected by mycoviruses and transmitted horizontally via hyphal anastomosis. So the application of the mycoviruses, so these viruses can use to protect the plant from the fungal disease. So mycoviruses could be a potential antifungal biocontrol to save the plant from the pathogenic fungus. Or we can say that we can use these viruses to plant against the pathogenic fungus. So these are the sources from the information were taken to this lecture. I hope this presentation will enhance your knowledge. Best wishes. Thank you. Stay home. Stay safe. Thank you.